morning, students. Today we will discuss creativity and intelligence. So you will learn in that there are differences in potential for creativity across individuals. Some are highly creative and others are not so creative. Some may express creativity in writing, still others in dance, music, poetry, science, and so on. So here is one question: who can be creative? Creativity is not just for artists, musicians, writers, and designers. We all are creative. But the people who are known for it have spent time cultivating it, failing at it, and working at it. Only those are creative. Here is one definition. According to Webster Dictionary, artistic or intellectual inventiveness, creativity involves the generation of new ideas, novel ideas, brings into existence something new. This is a definition of creativity. Here is creativity is describable and satisfying. Here is some points of describable and satisfying, novel, useful, and understandable. Here is creativity can be observed in a novel solution to a problem, an invention, composition of a poem, painting, new chemical process, an innovation in law, and breakthrough in preventing a disease and the like. Despite differences, one common element among these, this is production of something new and unique. So through novel, creativity is describable and satisfying. Here is creativity needs. First is skill, second is talent, and third one is personality. We generally think of creativity in terms of creative person like Tagore, Einstein, C.V. Raman, Ramanujan, etc., who have made outstanding contribution in different spheres. In recent years, our understanding of creativity has broadened. Creativity is not just limited to a selected few, like artist, scientist, poet, or an inventor. An ordinary individual who has engaged in simple occupation like pottery, carpentry, cooking, etc., can also be creative. Here is, creativity can come in different forms like scientific, artistic, musical, creative writing. We are saying in this form creativity can come. So this is a creativity here. Creativity and intelligence. Let's take an example of two students in class to understand what is the relationship between creativity and intelligence. Is it positive or negative? Let's take an example of two students. Sunita is regarded by her teachers as an excellent student. She does her work on time, scores the highest grades in her class, listens to the instructions with care, grasps quickly, reproduces accurately, but she rarely comes out with ideas which are her own. Rita is another student who just averages in her studies and has not achieved high grades consistently. She prefers to learn on her own. She improvises new ways of helping her mother at home and comes up with new ways of doing her work and assignments. The former is considered to be more intelligent and the latter as more creative. So, thus a person who has the ability to learn faster and reproduce accurately may be considered intelligent, more than creative, unless she or he devises new ways of learning and doing. Terman, in the 1920s, found that persons with high IQ were not necessarily creative. So, here is a difference between creativity and intelligence. Creativity. In creativity, this test uses open-ended question. So they permit the person to think of different answers to question or problems in terms of his or her experiences, whatever this may have been. So in intelligence, this test uses closed-ended question, and in creative tests focus on divergent thinking, and intelligence test they focus on assessing abilities. See relationship between arrange unrelated things. Person has to think right solution in intelligence test. So in the relationship between creativity and intelligence, we can say here that is positive, not negative. So this is about creativity and intelligence. Next time we will start next chapter. Thank you.